Hello everyone, welcome to Terra Spatial. So in this video I am going to show you how to delineate watershed using Hark Hydro tool. Okay, so first of all I am going to just enable the tool here. So you can see here, just click here, automatically the tool will be added. So if you are facing any problem in downloading and installing the Hark Hydro tool, I have added the description in the above link as well as in the video description. So come, let's go to the video straight away. So first we have to add our dem data here. So this is the data from which we are going to process the watershed. Okay, and go to the option terrain processing and just select dem manipulation. You can see the option fill sinks. Okay, just select it. The dem data will be automatically added here. You can just rename the file fill. Okay, if you want you can just rename it and just give OK. The process will be starting. So you can see here the fill sinks operation is being successfully completed. So just give OK and go to the option table of contents. I'm just disabling my dem here and just adding the fill here so that we can visualize. So you can see here the fill is being completed successfully. Okay, so the next step will be flow direction. So go to the option terrain processing and you can see here flow direction. So this is the next step, just select it and you can see here in the place of hydro dam the fill has been automatically added, and just give OK in order to complete the process. So you can see here the flow direction has been successfully completed. I'm just showing it to you here. You can see the flow direction has been completed successfully. Okay, and make sure you just save the document. Go to the option file and just save it so that you don't lost your data, working data here. Save it. So the next step will be flow accumulation. Go to the option terrain processing and just click flow accumulation. Okay, so it has been automatically taken the flow direction which was processed earlier, and you can see here in the flow accumulation grid you can just change the name or you can just leave it as it is. Okay, and just give OK in order to start the processing. So you can see here the process has been completed successfully. Just give OK. So the next step will be steam definition. So come down here, you can see the option steam definition here, just click on it. So you can see here and it doesn't have the area, so it might be coming in for you. It's not showing for me here. And just give OK in order to complete the process. So you can see here the steam definition is being successfully completed. So the next is steam segmentation. You can see the option here, steam segmentation. Just click and it will be asking flow direction, stream grid and sink and sinkling grid. So we are just inputting the flow direction and stream grid, okay, in order to generate the stream link field. Okay, and just give OK. Just give OK. So the next step will be catchment grid delineation. So come down to the option terrain processing. You can see here the catchment grid delineation is available. Just click on it. So in order to calculate the catchment grid, this process is being used. Just give OK. So as you can see here, the catchment grid delineation has been successfully completed. So now I'm going to just show you the results here. I'm just disabling my dam data here, and you can see the flow direction. So you can see the lines here. There's not been that much. Yeah, you can see here. That is the flow accumulation, and you can see the stream definition here. These are the results from that, and this is stream segmentation. Okay, so finally we got the results of the catchment area. So you can see here. I'm adding my dam data here. You can see these are the catchment area available. So the next thing is that we are going to convert this catchment into polygons. Okay, so for that go to the option terrain pre-processing, and you can see the option catchment polygon processing. Just click here. So you have to just add the catchment grid here. It will be automatically added, and you have to just give OK in order to complete the process. So it has been successfully completed. So you can see here, I'm just disabling everything. You can see the catchment which has been converted into polygons. So the next thing is that we are going to process drainage line processing. Go to the option terrain processing. You can see the option drainage line processing. Just click here. So you can see here the stream link grid will be added, and the flow direction will be ordered in order to process the drainage line processing. Okay, and just give OK in order to complete it. So it has been successfully completed, and we are going to just see here. The drainage line has been added here, you can see. So the next thing is that we are going to adjoin the catchment. Okay, so go to the option terrain processing. So you can see the option adjoin catchment processing. Okay, now just click here. And just give OK. So the process has been completed. I'm just showing you the results here. So this is the results from the adjoint catchment. So you can see the difference out here. I'm just changing the color. You can see here, and you can compare with the previous catchment. It has been just merged together. It is a catchment merging. Okay, so the next step will be point delineation. So using the point, we are going to delineate a watershed. Okay, so I'm just disabling the catchment area in order to visualize it properly. Okay, so the next thing will be point delineation. So you can see the option here. This is the tool for it. Just click here. Okay, and now we have to select snap stream grid. So for that we are going to select stream link. Okay, and here you can see the option stream link. Okay, now just give OK. Now come down to the area for which you need to delineate the watershed. So I'm going to select this one. I'm going to select here. Try to zoom it. And just make a point here. Automatically, the watershed will be created. So you can see here, do you want to save the watershed? And just give yes. So we need to just name it. Watershed 1. Okay. And just give OK. So you can see here, the watershed has been delineated here. So we can also manually do it here. Okay. So you can just see the table of contents. There's a watershed being created using the point. Okay. So now we are going to just clip the watershed. So now what we have to do, we have to go to the option geoprocessing, from there select clip. So our input feature will be the drainage line. Okay. And our clip features will be watershed. And just give OK. So you can see here, the watershed has been created. So just open your table of contents, just remove everything. So you can see here, the watershed has been generated successfully. You can do it, you can do for the rest of the watershed also using the point feature. Okay. So if you have any further doubts in delineating the watershed, you can just ask in the comment sections. So I'll be replying to it. Okay. So now I'm just, you can just visualize it here. I'm just going to the option properties. And just changing the color. Can see here, yeah, just click here and just I'm applying it here, and you can see here the watershed has been successfully delineated. So if you do like this video, please give a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.